Greetings from Ken Law. Today is Friday, June 2nd, 2023. You know, in order to prepare for this video yesterday, I read the first chapter in this book called The New Testament in Cross-Cultural Perspective by Richard Rohrbaugh. Now, I have learned that the best way to read theology is when it's hot and sunny outside, I lie out by the pool working on my tan, you know, while I'm reading all this stuff. Truthfully, how can life be better? Now, this guy, Richard Rohrbaugh, he does an excellent job in pointing out how the American culture is so much different than what the culture was like in biblical days. On page 3, Rohrbaugh points out that contrary to what many Americans believe, the Bible was not written specifically for Americans. You know, well, actually, we all know that, since we Canadians know that the Bible was written just for us. And I'd like to say, and the Americans and Canadians who think that the Bible was written for them are the same people who will tell you that if the King James Version of the Bible was good enough for the Apostle Paul, then it is good enough for us. I say amen to that, brothers and sisters. And you know, over the years, I have actually met some people who truly believe that. Very interesting. Well, in reading this chapter, there were a number of things that I never knew, and they would be considered an aha moment. The first one is in regard to the eye. You know, in our culture, most people know that light enters the eye through the cornea and then through some amazing processes we can see. But that is totally different to what the ancients believed about the eye. Plutarch, he was a Greek philosopher who lived from 46 AD to 119 AD. He tells us that the human eye had the power of releasing invisible rays of energies, that in some cases were potent enough to kill small children and small animals. You know, when I read this, I wondered if this is where the writers of Superman thought of giving him infrared vision. Sorry, I digress, but that's truly what I thought of. But as Rohrbaugh says, the point is that the ancients understood that light came out from the eye. This is something I never knew before, and it gives a whole different meaning to what Jesus said in Matthew 6:22, where he says, "The eye is the lamp of the body." And we all know that a lamp produces light. So Jesus is telling us that our eyes are emitting light. That is quite fascinating. Now, there is a Jewish work called the Book of Sirach, which was written around 200 BC. In this book, it says, "The eyes of the Lord are 10,000 times brighter than the sun." Once again, we are being told that light comes out of the eyes. As Spock would say, fascinating. You know, Canada and the US were both founded by the British, and both of us speak English, though I have heard many Americans tell me they speak American. Even though both of our countries do speak English, the American culture is so very different from our Canadian culture. Rohrbaugh points out that the American culture is the most individualistic culture that has ever existed. You know, Americans love to say, "I have my rights," whereas Canadians in general are more concerned for the good of the many and not for the good of the individual. Rohrbaugh points out that in Jesus' time, Christians were concerned for the many. You know, this is so evident when you look at Acts 2:44 and 45. It says, "And all who believed were together and had all things in common. And they sold their possessions and goods and distributed them to all as many had need." This is socialism in the finest. And a lot of Americans are so set against the example of the early Christians when it comes to socialism. Let me give you a good example. I love listening to Dr. David Jeremiah, who is truly a godly man. But here is what he said one time from the pulpit. He said, if we in America are not careful, we could become socialistic, just like they are up in Canada. When Darlene and I heard that, we laughed and laughed. Those evil Canadians. Now, there are two things that I read in this chapter that I would consider, really? The first is in regards to psychology. In this chapter, Rohrbach tells us that psychology is imagined to explain nearly every behavior Westerners observe. Whereas Rohrbach tells us that collective cultures like the early Christian church would have considered psychology irrelevant. That to me is a, really? The second pertains to the smile. I love to smile, as I think smiling is contagious. You know, one time I was in downtown Toronto on business, and a colleague stopped me on the street and said, Ken, you are always smiling and look so very happy. But I was shocked when Rohrbach said that in a lot of Asian cultures, if you smile at a stranger, they will think you're rude or a sexual deviant. Can you imagine a sexual deviant just because you smile at someone? So the next time I'm walking in an Asian community, I will not smile at strangers. Darlene also pointed out to me that if you watch a lot of Asian females, when they smile, they will put their hand up to their face to cover up the smile. Once again, differences in culture. In conclusion, I have never really thought much about the differences in culture and how the culture of the early Christians was so different than ours. But thanks be to our very fine professor who is wonderfully leading us down this learning path. So with that said, may the good Lord be with him and you until we meet again.